Aboriginal artists from outback New South Wales are using their skills to shed light on water issues along the Darling River and bring the bush to the city. Their work is on display along with other Australian artists who have visited the devastated river.
On the banks of the Darling River, Eddie Harris swaps stories with his Barkindji community.
Enjoying the water and what's around it is a good feeling.
Mr. Harris is one of a group of Barkindji artists sharing their message to visitors.
I paint it in a way that it shows how connected we are to country. For instance, the river running, knowing where those deep holes are, those circles.
William Badger Bates also has work on display. He says he uses his art to document history, like Australia's largest fish kills seen in Menindee over December and January.
But sometimes it's best to put a point across with art, and then I'm not only putting the point across and saying this is wrong, but also I'm teaching the younger generation.
River on the Brink is an exhibition which focuses on the ongoing devastation of the Murray-Darling Basin. Artists from the bush and across Australia have their work exhibited here in Sydney.
Ben Quilty spent some time in Wilcannia 6 years ago. He says he couldn't believe the state of the river then or how little has changed since.
I mean, it wasn't a river in 2013. It was just an empty trench that you could walk across anywhere along the length of it where we were camped. I'm not surprised by anything. I think the river will continue to disintegrate and fall apart until there's such a pushback from people who believe in science that people will actually act and change it.
The exhibition's curator Gavin Wilson says he hopes the exhibition will light a fire under visitors.
And what I want people to come out of this with is a sense of anger.
The federal government this week allocated a further $300,000 in funding to help states manage extreme fish kills this summer. Anita Bolle, SBS World News.